Jamal, that I respected him. I respected him for saying to me, for hearing him say that the remembrance of Allah is very important. Because some people were saying, don't remember Allah. You have to remember Allah when you eat, when you sleep, everywhere. You can't say, there's not a place where you don't remember Allah. So that's one thing that I agreed with him on, remembrance of Allah a lot. This is the sign of a munafiq, a hypocrite, is he doesn't remember Allah. In the Quran it says, وَلَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. That means the munafiq, he doesn't remember Allah a lot. So if you want to know a sign of a munafiq, he hardly remembers Allah. But a sign of a believer, يَذْكُرُونَ ذَكْرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَذَكْرَاتِ. So that's a sign of belief, he remembers Allah a lot. So that's one thing positive that I agreed with him on, and alhamdulillah, like, I just wanted to say that. Because I don't want him to think, oh, Modin doesn't like me, or I just, obviously there's things I don't like, and he doesn't like about me, I don't like about him, that's okay, but... Like I said, we all differ of opinions. Even in the time of the Imam Ali, the Khawarij, I'm not trying to say Khawarij, but there was a battle of the Khawarij and Imam, battle of Nahrawan, have you heard of it? Where the Khawarij fighted against Imam Ali. Thousands of people were killed, and there was a lot of battles after the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alayhi died. Yeah, so obviously, I would say to you, if you was there at that time, would you go with the Khawarij or would you go with Imam Ali?
I'll go with Imam Ali.
You'd go with Imam Ali? Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa Muhammad. I'm not going to lie.
But there's no Shias at that time.
No. All right, good question.
There's no Shias.
All right, good question. He said, okay. That's a good question from the brother. He said, where did the Shias come? Because there was no Shias at that time. I just wanted to say to the brother that after there was no Shia at the time of the Prophet Muhammad, I think there was no Shia of the there was no Shia or Sunni. It was all Muslim and Sahaba, right? But after the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa died, there was wars. So there was three wars. There was the war with Muawiyah, there was the war with Aisha, and there was the war with the Khawarij. The ones that went on the side of Imam Ali were called Shi'at Ali. So then that word became like, oh, are you with Ali or Muawiyah? If you say you're with Ali, they say you're Shi'at Ali. Because it's in the Quran, هذا من شيعتي هذا من عدوي إن إبراهيم كان من شيعة نوح. You understand?
But that verse has a specific context to it.
Yeah,
it doesn't justify what you are Shia.
No, I have said to the people, do not call yourself Shia. I've said, Shia Blade Runner, for example, I told him, I saw him, I said, why are you calling yourself Shia? Don't move that name. You're not meant to call yourself Shia Blade Runner. He said, show me the proof. I've got the proof. There's a hadith from the imam, well, from our imams. We got 12 imams. People came to him and said, we are Shia. He said, don't say that. He said, you're not our Shia. You're not my Shia. Unless you're the Sahaba, the proper Sahaba. Like the son of Abu Bakr, the brother of Aisha, I love him. Muhammad ibn Abi Bakr, he said he's the true Shia of the Imam Ali. Ammar ibn Yasir. Salman al-Farisi, Ammar, Abu Dhar. The source is just from the Al-Bukhs, Bihar al-Anwar, al-Kafi. But obviously, I'll bring you from the Quran. Like when Moses was fighting, they said he's from the Shia of Moses. Remember the guy that backed him?
That doesn't justify being a Shia as a
group. No. I'm totally against anyone calling themselves Shia. It's wrong to call yourself Shia. Just say it's wrong. Because if you're not on that level, if you're not on that level, sorry? One second.
Alawi, Rafida, 12 verse,
It's not the same. Who says that?
Alawis.
Alawis are in Turkey and Syria.
Yeah. And they worship Alawis.
I'm not too familiar with their belief, but...
I'll tell you
their beliefs. No. What, Alawis?
Yeah.
But where are they based in? Kurdish, right? Or Turkish?
Syria.
I think Ali Da'wah, his parents are Alawi, I think.
I don't know.
I'm not sure.
Maybe.
Ali Da'wah's parents.
Alawis believe Imam, they worship Bashar.
No. It's not Bashar. Bro. Listen, let me just...
They say it on the TV, man. They said it. We worship Bashar before we
worship
Allah.
Can I say something? That's... What, you know,
it's
Imam
Ibn Taymiyyah said they're worse than the Jews and the Christians.
No, Imam Ali, the Prophet Muhammad said to Imam Ali, two people will be cursed.
Bob, I'm telling you what the Alawis are saying.
No, we have Alawites.
Are you Alawi?
Northern Greece.
Oh, in
Macedonia.
Okay.
Where I'm from. we have Allah. They used to be called Bektashis.
Yeah.
They're like crypto Shia. They venerate Ali and the Ahl al-Bayt.
Yeah.
So even to such an extent that even the Shia consider them to be ghulat. They're too extreme to be considered mainstream Shia.
Even the Rafidah.
Now they don't even call themselves Bektashis. They call themselves Alawi.
Yeah.
It's the political influence of the Alawis of Iran and Turkey and...
Brother, you know the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, he said, oh Ali, you will be like the Jesus. Some people will, like, you know, Jesus, they worshipped him, and that's wrong. So some people that worshipped Ali, that's wrong. And some people will hate you, like Jesus, the Jews hated him. Huh? The shirk, of course the shirk.
So you're Kafir?
Yeah.
Alawi Kafir.
Like, no, if he says, no, anyone who
worships,
anyone who...
I'm just going to make a point, yeah? Saudi Arabia have spent over 50 billion, number one on military expenditure. And they still have lost against the Houthis, who are walking with sandals. How can people walking with sandals defeat an army that spent over $50 billion on the military, which is the highest military expenditure in the history, okay? If you look it up. And they still lose. لأن سيد القرآن سوف ينفقون أمواله ثم تكون عليهم حسرة. They're gonna spend their money, then it's gonna be a misery for them. صدق الله العظيم.
It's time to rain the Houthis back my own.
Can I just say something? I just saw a Saudi guy. We had a little. They were coming at to me. I said, listen, I don't hate no one. I love everyone. Yeah.
We don't support Saudi.
I know. No.
Tahut.
Yeah. No. Okay. I respect you for that. I respect you for saying that.
We talk about the regime, not the constitution, yeah, not the people.
Okay. I respect you for saying that.
Between the constitution and the layman.
Okay. That's okay. Okay. I respect you for that. What I'm trying to say, because Yemen is a Sunni country, it's not Yemen is a Sunni country.
The majority are
50 billion.
Zaydi are Sunni, bro.
No, they're not Sunni.
Brother,
they have spent over 50 billion.
Bro, let me explain something.
They're distinct.
Yeah, but the Zaydis believe in the Khulafa, the four Khulafa.
That's the thing.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So they're very close to the Sunnah. They're like almost 100% Sunnah. Even. Yeah, but they're very close to the Sunnah.
They're not
okay.
Yeah, but they believe in the Khulafa.
There are some Zaydis who are extremists, and they perform Sabba Sahaba. So they can't.
Alright, brother, can I?
Yeah, there are different factions.
They do
the
Sabba Sahaba.
Some of them.
And you guys bury daughters, okay? The Wahhabis.
Not Greek, like I told you. Greek. I'm not even a Muslim.
You know what?
Are you from Greece?
My Greek brother. My Greek brother. What does he? What's the affiliation?
The Shia and Muslim ancestors as well. Ottoman Greeks from Anatolia and Georgia.
Brother, so you don't have a religious affiliation?
Well, I have a mixed affiliation.
What is your faith?
Islam.
Of Islam?
I'm not going to be. It's not about me.
No, I'm just asking you a basic question.
Knowing about the topic doesn't necessarily mean that.
Nawdeen says that he agrees with me about the dhikr of Allah, but what about coming to the Quran and Sunnah, be Faham al Sahaba and the Salaf al Salih?
Okay, can I ask you?
What about that?
I'm going to ask you. A'udhu billahi minash-shaytan ar-rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. First of all, if you want the true Sunnah, yeah, you get it from. It came from Allah to Jibreel to the Prophet's house, because the angel Gabriel used to come in the Prophet's house. Even Imam Ja'far Sadiq used to say, I can tell you about the footsteps of the angel. I can show you the footsteps of angel Gabriel in our house in Medina. So when the wahi comes down to the house of the Prophet, we say that the strongest person.
Does it come all the time?
No, when the wahi comes, he comes to the house of the Prophet. What I'm trying to say is that the Sunnah, even in all the Sunni books, six Sunni Sahih books say the Prophet said, I leave with you two things, the Quran and my family. This is in Nasa'i, Bukhari, Muslim. You agree with that? Alhamdulillah. No, did you hear what he said? He just said, he agrees with the hadith, I leave with me two things, the Quran and my Ahlul Bayt.
Yeah, we all do.
If you agree with that, Alhamdulillah. And this is... Alright, I'm going to ask that. The reason why, even Shamsi said, no, Aisha's not included because it's Kisa. You know Kisa? The Kisa was five people. Muhammad, Ali, Fatima, Hassan, Hussein. Even Nasa'i, and Nasa'i says, the wives are not included in the Ahlul Bayt. because they can be divorced. If she gets divorced and go back to her,
they're all included. They're all included.
No, sir. They're all included. The wives, yeah, it's the family.
The wives are part of the family.
The wives are part of the family, you know?
The Prophet's wives.
Can I say something?
Is your wife part of your family?
All right, can I say something?
So is your sister part of your family?
Can I say something? If one of the nine wives gets divorced and goes back to her parents, brother, I'm just asking.
They
won't
get divorced. But they didn't get divorced.
Okay, I'm just saying.
But they didn't get divorced.
No, I'm just
saying.
Tell me, did they get divorced? Yes or no?
Okay, I'm going to answer you in 1 minute. Let me ask you. So if she got divorced and went back to her parents' house, for example, is she still considered Ahlul Bayt? I just want to ask you this question.
No,
she's not considered. Okay.
But she didn't get divorced.
Okay, now, okay, that's a good question as well. Okay, what's up? So, what we're trying to say is that if it's a possibility.
Do you accept Aisha the wife of Muhammad Sallallahu
Alaihi Wasallam? She was one of the nine wives.
Nine wives.
You have to respect the other eight wives.
Yes. Okay, yeah,
we do. You just don't focus on one wife.
So, what I'm trying to say
is. Some narrations say 11.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, yeah. Okay. We respect all of
you. Focus on one wife. Yeah. Focus on all. You have to also talk about the.
Yeah, so Ahlul Bayt, sorry. In the Sahih books, it says the Ahlul Bayt are the people of the Kisa, the family. Muhammad, Ali, Fatima, Hassan, Hussein. What I want to say, brother, I'm trying to say is that a lot of people, they follow their parents, yeah? You know this, innit? If their parents Hindu, they become Hindu. If their parents Salafi, they become Salafi. Parents Shia, they become Shia. I'm not going to lie to you, bro.
My parents are friendly.
Friendly, yeah? What's that? I don't know. Anyway, you're big up, yeah? But listen, what I'm trying to say, brother, is that we're all here to learn. We're not here to fight, alhamdulillah. Because, you know, some people...
But you still haven't answered the question.
We can discuss. Exactly.
No, is Aisha part of the family or not?
Brother, I said to you, according to Sunni scholars...
So she is.
Ahlul Bayt, the wives are not included in Ahlul Bayt. According to Sunni scholars. The Ahlul Bayt are five.
That's not correct.
Muhammad,
not correct.
Ali, Fatima, Hassan,
that's
Hussein.
That's not correct, bro.
Sorry?
That's not correct, bro. That's not
the
correct.
Sunni scholars? Which one? Okay, who's the most authentic one? You got Bukhari, Muslim, Tirmidhi, Nisa'i. There's one more authentic than Bukhari. What's his name? Ibn
Albani.
Not Albani. There's one that's Bukhari says he's 100%.
Which one?
Not Ibn Majah.
There's a Muslim that Bukhari is the most authentic book after the Quran. For hadith.
No, Al-Kafi is.
No, it's not. Al-Kafi, where? Who said?
Al-Kafi is.
Who said?
Have you heard of Al-Kafi?
Shia scholars.
No. Okay, hold on, brother. I'm not what happened.
Black Dunya, right?
Huh?
Black Dunya, right?
He's not Black Dunya.
The channel. No. He's not Black Dunya. No. He's
not Black Dunya.
Black Dunya.
I'm White Dunya.
The problem with you.
With what?
Let me tell you something.
Don't worry.
You said in the title, grave worshippers, right? That's your knowledge. But let me correct you. Even some Sunni imams say it's okay to visit the grave.
Yes.
Okay? Yeah, but not all Sunnis agree on that case. Okay?
Which Sunni scholar say?
I know which one that forbid it. I know.
We visited Abu Hanifa's grave in Iraq. Bukhari's got a grave. The Prophet Muhammad's got a grave.
The grave. That's
Abu Bakr's got a grave. Umar's got a grave.
Do you visit Abu Bakr
in Medina?
No, we don't worship it.
Okay. Good point. Good question. Good question. If I give you the Quran and I tell you to kiss it, would you kiss it?
Of course. Yes. No problem.
Are you worshiping the leather?
No.
You're worshiping in the Quran.
Kissing is not worship.
You're respecting
it. I respect.
So when I go to the grave of the Prophet and I kiss it, I'm not worshiping it, true, but I'm respecting it.
We're not saying.
I'm just saying. Because he's talking about.
Where?
No, he's talking.
Hold on.
I'm just saying about the.
Wait, do you ask for help? Do you ask why I help?
Okay.
From
good question.
Hassan.
Let me ask you.
Let's hear him, because we can't all ask questions. When you say, Iyakana Bodu, Iyakana
Stayin, okay, let me ask
Ibn Abbas. Only tafsir said, only we see Allah from, yeah. We only see help from Allah.
Okay.
Ibn Abbas is tafsir. Now you bring me tafsir.
This, I agree with you. We should only seek help from Allah. Regarding, you're talking about the dead people. Can we get help? I'm going to ask you all a question.
Allah says in the Quran.
No, 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 because this question is related to it.
Okay, Allah said in the Quran, the dead and the knock and the dead here.
Okay.
No, Allah said, wait, 1 minute. Allah said in the Quran, brother, you asked a question. You said the dead cannot hear. You said the dead cannot hear. Correct? That's not correct, because Allah said the shuhada, al-shuhada, they are alive.
The shuhada are alive. They've gone from this dunya.
They are alive. وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ قُتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلَ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتٍ الْأَحْيَاءَ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ يُرْزَقُونَ.
What does that mean?
Translate it.
You mean they are alive?
Don't assume the shuhada are dead. Except they are with Allah.
Are they alive in this dunya?
The shuhada.
Okay. Are they alive in the dunya?
Okay, where is Allah?
Not in the dunya, with Allah they are.
They are alive with Allah, but where is Allah?
Allah is of the arsh.
Oh no, that's shirk. Whoever says Allah is on something, in something, or from something, has committed shirk.
Over the arsh, above the arsh.
This is.
We don't know how.
Why are you taking it literally?
No, we don't take it literally.
You don't take it literally.
What do you mean?
You said you have to take
Abu Hanifa
when he says it's still on the arsh. Okay, let me ask you a question. Why does there was a sheikh in Saudi?
When the blind woman said, "I'm Allah."
A blind. Okay. A blind woman. Hold on. Doesn't Allah say? Hold on.
The slave.
When doesn't say Allah in the Quran? Whoever is blind in this life will be blind in the next life. No. Why don't you take it literally? No. That's the haqiqah. Why don't you take it literally that when it says in the Quran, whoever is blind in this life will be blind in the next life. Why have you not taken this literally and you have taken istawa ala al-arsh literally? You have
because
taken Allah's got hands and legs.
No, hold on. The ulama have ijma upon this. Imam Qurtubi.
Hold on. But you left Ahlul Bayt.
Wait. Do you know what arsh is? Do you know
what arsh is? The throne.
When the slave girl came, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi bring the slave girl here. And what did Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi say? Ayn Allah. And when she said "Fis sama," Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, "Free this. She's a believer."
Is that what? Is that which?
Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala says,
"Bukhari."
Yeah, Allah says, "I'm more closer to you than your jugular vein." So what? Hold on. What's the book?
In the
brother, let me ask
the book.
No, one second. Can I say something, brother?
Allah is free for
Have you read Imam Ali's Nahj al-Balagha?
Ya akhi, no, I don't want to record it, please.
Have you read the sermon of Imam Ali describing Allah? وَمَا يُؤْمِنَ أَكْثَرُهُمْ إِلَّا وَهُمْ مُشْرِكُونَ. Brother, you know this could be a minor shirk what you're doing.
Don't divert the topic. We're going back. Is Hussein alive or not alive? Is Hussein dead or alive?
Okay, hold on. Do you say
he's dead? He's not dead because in the Quran it says, don't assume the shuhada are dead.
Two ayahs in the Quran it says, وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ قُتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ
أَمْوَاتٍ. He's a kafir.
One second.
Abu Hanifa in his Fiqh Akbar is known. In Fiqh Akbar, he said, you can't even say Allah's in the heavens. You can't. You have said over the fifth sama.
Okay, can I say something? First of all, we jumped a few times.
Abu Hanifa no. Every Shia.
No. They're saying that Allah is
alive or dead.
Okay.
I say he's alive because in the Quran it says.
What's the actual subject?
Wala tahsabanna
alladhina qutilu fi sabilillah. We're a lot of things. First of all,
stick with one and stop jumping around.
Alright, which one shall we stick to? The one if they're alive or
Allah alive, just like he described them in the Quran.